This video will use graphics and the Armillary sphere to illustrate concepts of lunar phases and then focus on the question, which phases can be seen at a particular time of day. We start with a view from the North Celestial Pole showing the direction of sunlight, Earth, and the Moon in its orbit. From this perspective, the Moon revolves around the Earth, moving counterclockwise, and the Earth rotates counterclockwise as well. We recognize 8 distinct phases of the Moon. Note that each of these is separated by an integer multiple of 45 degrees from the Sun. Half of the lunar surface is always illuminated. If we draw a line from the Sun to the center of the Moon and then draw in the perpendicular bisector to this line, cutting the Moon in half, we identify the half of the Moon that is illuminated and the half in shadow. This works for Earth too. To determine the appearance of each phase, we draw a line from the center of Earth to the center of the Moon and then draw in its perpendicular bisector. This identifies the half of the lunar surface that is seen from Earth and allows one to visualize its appearance. Note that the direction of the Sun allows one to specify time zones on Earth. We have noon towards the Sun, midnight on the far side of Earth, and the direction of rotation allows us to add 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. We can now identify the meridian time, when each phase is highest in the sky. We can also place tangent lines to a hypothetical observer in a certain time zone and visualize the phases of the Moon that they are able to see at that time. Let's picture an observer at 6 p.m. and draw on a tangent plane to that observer's location. Easy to do for this enlarged Earth, but more accurate when Earth is correctly scaled relative to the size of the Moon's orbit. Note that our observer can see everything on one side of the tangent plane and nothing on the other, as this is the region hidden by Earth. At 6 p.m., we note the waxing crescent, first quarter, and waxing gibbous can be easily seen, and the new moon and full moon partially seen. We can also visualize lunar phases by making use of an armillary celestial sphere. Here our observer is at the center of a horizon representation of the celestial sphere. We note the cardinal points along the horizon. For a northern hemisphere observer at a mid-latitude of 40 degrees, we can see the north celestial pole at an altitude of 40 degrees above the north point of the horizon. The celestial equator runs from the east point to the west point, crossing the observer's meridian at an altitude of 90 degrees minus the observer's latitude, so 50 degrees. We will assume that the Sun and Moon are always on the celestial equator, rather than in an approximately 60 degree wide band centered on the celestial equator. We can describe a certain time by the location of the Sun. For 6 a.m., the Sun would be on the eastern horizon. We see the new moon in the same direction as the Sun, and then at positions increasing by 45 degree angles from the Sun: waning crescent, 45 degrees, third quarter, 90 degrees, waning gibbous, 135 degrees, and then full moon at the western horizon, which has just set. Let's apply these skills to solve a hypothetical problem. Joe takes the bus home from school each night at 10:30 p.m. As he waits for the bus at 10:30 p.m., what phases can he see over a month of time? We return to our view of the lunar orbit from the North Celestial Pole, note the time zones on Earth, and draw on a tangent plane at the 10:30 p.m. observer's time zone. We note the position of the lunar orbit our observer can see and the portion he can't see due to Earth. At 10:30 p.m. on the realistically sized Earth, we note that the first quarter, waxing gibbous, full moon, and waning gibbous can be seen, while the third quarter, waning crescent, new moon, and waxing crescent can never be seen. Note that at 10:30 p.m., the Sun is well below the western horizon, almost to midnight. We note the phases of the Moon at 45 degree incremental separations from the Sun. The waxing crescent is still below the horizon, but our observer can see first quarter, waxing gibbous, full moon, and waning gibbous. Let's check our understanding using a follow-up peer instruction question. Suppose Carol takes the bus to school each morning at 7:30 a.m. What phases of the Moon can she see at 7:30 a.m. waiting for the bus over a month of time? Classroom students should follow normal procedures or instructor guidelines. Viewers not in a classroom should record your vote and explain your reasoning on a piece of paper. Please pause this video and answer the question. We return to our graphic of the North Celestial Pole view of the lunar orbit and draw in a tangent plane for an observer in that time zone on Earth. Note that the phases of waning gibbous, third quarter, waning crescent, and new moon could be seen. It's 7:30 a.m., so the sun has been up above the eastern horizon for an hour and a half. The waning gibbous moon is 345-degree steps away from the sun near the western horizon. Here's my bus. Time to head for school. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.